Blessed be God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen. There is one body and one spirit. There is one hope to which we are called, one Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One Lord and Father.
Peace be with you.
And also
please be seated. Welcome to Portsmouth Cathedral. Whether you are one of the few here in the cathedral this afternoon, or the many more joining us through the live feed or catching up with the service over the next few days, everyone is welcome as we share together in this celebration of the Christian faith. And of the calling into which God invites each one of us. Those who are joining virtually are not members of an audience or spectators this afternoon, but fully participants with those of us who can be present in person. And I invite everyone to take as full a part as possible in the service. Here today, as I say, we reflect on the invitation God offers to each one of us to respond to his call as we celebrate Catherine's response and as she comes to be ordained deacon. We are reminded that vocation is not something static or fixed, but dynamic and developing. And today, Catherine witnesses to that as she moves into the next stage of her ministry. For God calls his people to follow Christ and forms us into a royal priesthood, a holy nation, to declare the wonderful deeds of him who has called us out of darkness into his marvellous light. The Church is the body of Christ, the people of God, and the dwelling place of the Holy Spirit. In baptism, the whole Church is summoned to witness to God's love and to work for the coming of his kingdom. To serve this royal priesthood, God has given a variety of ministries. Deacons are ordained so that the people of God may be better equipped to make Christ known. Theirs is a life of visible self-giving. Christ is the pattern of their calling and their commission. As he washed the feet of his disciples, so they must wash the feet of others.
Reverend Father in God, I present Catherine Mary Edenborough to be ordained to the office of deacon in the Church of God.
Have those whose duty it is to know this ordinand and examine her found her to be of godly life and sanctity?
They have.
Do they believe her to be duly called to serve God in this ministry?
They do.
Catherine, do you believe that God is calling you to this ministry?
I do so believe.
Has this ordinand taken the necessary oaths and made the declaration of assent?
She has duly taken the oath of allegiance to the sovereign and the oath of canonical obedience to the bishop. She has affirmed and declared her belief in the faith which is revealed in the Holy Scriptures and set forth in the Catholic creeds, and to which the historic formularies of the Church of England bear witness.
Let us pray for Catherine and for the ministry of the whole people of God. God, our Father, Lord of all the world, through your Son, you have called us into the fellowship of your universal Church. Hear our prayer for your faithful people, that in their vocation and ministry, each may be an instrument of your love. Give to your servant now to be ordained the needful gifts of grace, through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
John, the sons of Zebedee, came forward to Jesus and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." And he said to them, "What is it you want me to do for you?" And they said to him, "Grant us to sit, one at your right hand and one at your left, in your glory." But Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?" They replied, "We are able." Then Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right hand or at my left is not mine to grant, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the 10 heard this, they began to be angry with James and John. So Jesus called them and said to them, "You know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize as their rulers lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you. But whoever wishes to become a great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be the slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. One of the really good things to come out of the strangeness of this time is that because she has already begun her curacy, we have got to know Catherine and to cherish her presence among us, so that we really feel that we can celebrate
the right, it's depicted in two threads laid side by side to represent not only the couple in the dance, but the whole of humanity. As she wrote when she was designing it, not a single strand, because we always exist in relationship. And on the left, under a gold and silver cross, the shape of the dance is depicted in three threads, showing our Trinitarian knot, not always obvious, but always present. Tiny beads are scattered around the patterns of the dance to depict the movement. So the dance of the Trinity, always in motion, always giving life and hope and abundance, is mirrored on earth by the relationships of humanity. Our dynamism, enabled by the constant invitation for us to be swept up into the movement of the three-person God. Because the astonishing truth is that, as Paul writes to the Romans, the only response to the extraordinary generosity and grace of God is to offer ourselves wholly to his will. Do not be conformed, he says. Be transformed. Be transformed by the shape of this dance, the shape which is always there, but always moving, the shape which invites you to dance with others and discover in and through them the beauty of our interdependence with each other and our dependence on God. So don't get above yourself, says Paul, by focusing on your individual status or needs or power. Get beyond yourself by recognizing that our gifts only make sense when they're lived out in love. There's a fragment of a verse in this passage of Romans about which there's a debate. Serve the Lord, says our translation, the Greek for Lord in this section being Kyrie. But some manuscripts have a different word with a couple of the letters changed. Instead of Kyrie, they have Kyra. Serve the time, serve the hour, serve the here and now. Catherine is being made a deacon so that she can serve for this time. This time of strangeness and sickness and anxiety and distancing and loneliness and pain. And also this time of courage and selflessness and resilience and opportunity and humanity and hope. She is being made a deacon so that through her the gifts of God can be poured out, the dance of the Trinity inviting in all whom she serves. She is being made a deacon so that she can live out her gifts in love, and so that she can remind us by her presence among us to do the same. To do the same through the cup and the baptism and the light and the joy of this hour. So rejoice in hope, says Paul, and we in this cathedral and parish are rejoicing in hope today. We wanted to give you something, Catherine, from our shop here as a token of our rejoicing. And during the week we were having a discussion in the office about what might be a good present. We weren't specifically talking about the origins of your stole at the time, but one person said, well, given the whole variety of things curates are called to do, a tea towel might not be a bad idea. Well, in normal times, I'd give you your present from all of us, but as it is, we'll find it like a life jacket under your seat with love from us all. A tea towel for your diaconal ministry. But we felt we couldn't leave it at that, so as this is the Church of England, there are also two other things no curate can be without: a mug and some tea. May God richly bless you.
proclaim the gospel in word and deed as agents of God's purposes of love. They are to serve the community in which they are set, bringing to the church the needs and hopes of all the people. They are to work with their fellow members in searching out the poor and weak, the sick and lonely, and those who are oppressed and powerless, reaching into the forgotten corners of the world, that the love of God may be made visible. Deacons share in the pastoral ministry of the church and in leading God's people in worship. They preach the word and bring the needs of the world before the church in intercession. They accompany those searching for faith and bring them to baptism. They assist in administering the sacraments. They distribute communion and minister to the sick and housebound. Deacons are to seek nourishment from the scriptures. They are to study them with God's people, that the whole church may be equipped to live out the gospel in the world. They are to be faithful in prayer, expectant and watchful for the signs of God's presence as he reveals his kingdom among us. Catherine, we trust that you are fully determined by the grace of God to give yourself wholly to his service, that you may draw his people into that new life which God has prepared for those who love you. And now, in order that we may know your mind and purpose, you must make the declarations we put to you. Do you accept the Holy Scriptures as revealing all things necessary for eternal salvation through faith in Jesus Christ?
I do so accept them.
Will you be diligent in prayer, in reading Holy Scripture, and in all studies that will deepen your faith and fit you to bear witness to the truth of the gospel?
By the help of God, I will.
Do you believe the doctrine of the Christian faith as the Church of England has received it? And in your ministry, will you expound and teach it?
I believe it and will do so.
Will you strive to make the love of Christ known through word and example, and have a particular care for those in need?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you be a faithful servant in the household of God after the example of Christ, who came not to be served but to serve?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you endeavour to fashion your own life and that of your household according to the way of Christ, that you may be a pattern and example to Christ's people?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you work with your fellow servants in the gospel for the sake of the kingdom of God?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you accept the discipline of this church and give due respect to those in authority?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you then, in the strength of the Holy Spirit, continually stir up the gift of God that is in you, grow in holiness and grace?
By the help of God, I will.
Brothers and sisters, you have heard how great is the charge that Catherine is ready to undertake, and you have heard her declarations. Is it now your will that Catherine should be ordained?
It is.
Will you continually pray for her?
We will.
Will you uphold and encourage her in her ministry?
We will.
In the name of our Lord, we bid you remember the greatness of the trust in which you are now to share, the ministry of Christ himself, who for our sake took the form of a servant. Remember always with thanksgiving that the people among whom you will minister are made in God's image and likeness, serving them, you are serving Christ himself, before whom you will be called to account. You cannot bear the weight of this calling in your own strength, but only by the grace and power of God. Pray, therefore, that your heart may daily be enlarged and your understanding of the Scriptures enlightened. Pray earnestly for the gift of the Holy Spirit. light the world, a holy people for your own possession, a royal priesthood, a universal church.
Lord, send your Spirit.
We praise and glorify you, because you sent your only Son, Jesus Christ, to take the form of a slave. He humbled himself for our sake, and in obedience accepted death, even death on a cross.
Lord, send your Spirit.
We praise and glorify you, because in every age you send your Spirit to fill those whom you have chosen, to equip your holy people for the work of ministry, for the building up of the body of Christ.
Lord, send your Spirit.
And now we give you thanks, because you have called this your servant, whom we ordain in your name, to share as a deacon in the ministry of the gospel of Christ, who came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for men.
Lord, send your Spirit.
Therefore, Father, through Christ our Lord we pray. Send down the Holy Spirit on your servant Catherine for the office and work of a deacon in your church. Through your Spirit, Heavenly Father, give this your servant grace and power to fulfill her ministry. Make her faithful to serve and constant in advancing your gospel in the world. May she follow the example of Jesus Christ, your Son, who washed the feet of his disciples and set the needs of others before his own. May her life be disciplined and holy. Her words declare your love, and her actions reveal your glory, that your people may walk with her in the way of truth, and be made ready for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, to whom, with you and your Holy Spirit, belong glory and honor, worship and praise, now and forever. Amen. Ordained and vested, Catherine turns to face the congregation. Will you please stand? We preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus as Lord, and ourselves as your servants for Jesus' sake. We welcome you as a fellow servant in the gospel. May Christ dwell in your heart, that you may be rooted and grounded in love. We are all one in Christ Jesus. We belong to him through faith, heirs of the promise of the Spirit of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
splendour and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours.
All things come from you,
and of your own do we give. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and good, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks and praise, through your servant, Jesus Christ our Lord. At his baptism, he was revealed as your beloved Son. Coming among us as one who serves, he taught us that the greatest in your kingdom are those who make themselves least and the servants of all. Although he was their teacher and their Lord, he washed the feet of his disciples and commanded us to do the same, that we might reveal the power of your love made perfect in our human weakness. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you, and saying,
Thank you.
prays and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine and blood may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Remember Justin, our Archbishop, and your servant Catherine, now ordained. May she be a faithful steward of your heavenly gifts. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Holy and blessed God, you have fed us with the body and blood of your Son and filled us with your Holy Spirit. May we honour you, not only with our lips, but in lives dedicated to the service of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Deliver to Catherine first the license, my license to serve as curate in this cathedral parish in the coming years, and secondly the letter of orders to prove, as it were, that what you have witnessed has taken place. And as I pass that, I also pass to her, much more importantly, a copy of the Holy Scriptures. Catherine, receive this book as a sign of the authority given you this day to speak God's word to his people, build them up in his truth, and serve them in his name. And now we pray for God's blessing on each one of us and those whom we are called to be with, to live amongst, to work with, and to serve in Christ's name. God, who has called you, is faithful. May the Father, whose glory fills the heavens, cleanse you by his holiness and send you to proclaim his word. Amen. May Christ, who has ascended to the heights, pour upon you the riches of his grace. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, equip you and strengthen you in your ministry. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Go